Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with a topic related to economy, and the name of the topic is FRDI Bill. Now from examination point of view, this is very important for general studies mains examination paper 3, plus this will also help the students of economics and public administration optional students. Now what is this bill about, FRDI Bill? Now the bill stands for Financial Resolution and Deposit Insurance Bill. In order to understand this bill, first of all we need to understand the financial market, how it works in the European countries and how it works in the developing countries, means in the socialist countries. Now when it comes to the working of the financial market, what it includes, first of all we need to know that. Now the financial market includes the banks, the insurance companies, and it also includes the pension sector. Now when it comes to all these sectors, they work with a lot of autonomy in the European countries. So whenever there is a kind of economic downturn or economic meltdown, and these sectors feel the heat of those meltdowns and economic downturns, generally there is a failure of either the banks or of the insurance companies or the pension sector. So in that case, generally what we believe is that the government will come out for the rescue of these banks, because in order to carry out the economy of any nation, it is very important. These sectors are very vital actually. But in the capitalist countries that work basically on the principle of the market, there is no substantive support provided by the government. So in the Western world, there is no provision like bailout thing, that the government will be coming out to rescue these sectors, be it the banking sector or the insurance sector or the pension sector. Now these sectors will have to devise out their own plans in order to create a situation favorable for them. So these sectors, be it the banking, insurance or the pension sector, they come out with a plan in order to resurrect themselves. Now how that is done? That is generally done by way of either merging two banks who are not doing well, or it is done by way of handing over their management to some other player, or it is done by a bail-in provision. Now what is this bail-in provision? Now bail-in primarily means that whatever sum was deposited in these companies, the insurance company, the bank or in the pension institution, that will be taken over by these institutions in order to mitigate their financial meltdown. Or the resolution is by way of liquidation of any such financial institution. So this is how it is carried out in the developed countries. But when it comes to the developing countries, generally these countries, developing countries, they have adopted the socialist kind of a constitution. Now because they have socialist base of the constitution, it is the primary responsibility of the governments to take care of the banks, the pension sector or any other financial institution existing. But of late, again what we have witnessed in the developing countries is a change in the winds of the economy. Now what it means, change in the winds of the economy? It means presently the government is not owning these sectors. These sectors are again owned by the private players, and the government of the developing country don't have the substantive amount in order to provide bailout to these institutions in case there is a failure of these institutions. So in the developing countries like India, now they are actually adopting the Western laws in order to cater to such kind of situations. Because in India, what we are witnessing is the downturn of the banks. The banks, they are having very high non-performing assets. Now, because the banks have a lot of NPAs, in that case, the banks actually require a lot of support from the government. But by bringing in this bill, what the government will ask for the banks, that they should not look at the government in order to seek any kind of support. Rather, they should come out with the solution from within. Either they should choose the path of liquidation, or they should choose the path of bail-in, or they should choose the path of mergering, or they should choose the path of handing over their management to someone else. Now, this is all what is contained in FRDI Bill, Financial Resolution and Deposit Insurance Bill. Now, this bill main focus is on categorizing the financial institutions. Now, it will create a body that is Resolution Corporation. Now, this is a very important body that will be created under this bill. Now, what will this body do? Now, this body will actually categorize all the financial institutions that are existing in India. The banks will be categorized, the insurance companies will be categorized, the pension institutions will be categorized. They are categorized in terms of their financial health. They will give actually a rating to these banks. And on the basis of the rating to these banks, the depositors, they will take a decision whether they want to invest or they don't want to invest. So at the face, it looks to be a good thing, but in reality, it is a bad thing. But the government, the reason for that is the government will not be coming to the rescue of these players anymore. The government don't want to take the responsibility because it pinches the government in terms of, because the government will not be able to meet the FRBM Act standards, Fiscal Responsibility and Budget Management Acts. So that is the reason why the government wants that it is better to categorize these institutions. Now, how the categorization will be done? The categorization will be done in terms of the economic health, how bad it is. Now, it will be categorized in terms of five parameters. The first parameter is low. It means there is a low amount of risk attached. The second is moderate. There is a moderate amount of risk attached. And the third is material. And the fourth is imminent. And the fifth is critical. So, when the institution will be categorized in terms of these risks, then the depositors will have the choice where to invest and where not to invest. And in case the financial institution will be categorized as critical, its operations will be taken over by the Resolution Corporation. And it is the Resolution Corporation will decide basically about whether to go in for bail-in, whether to go in for merger, or whether to go in for liquidation. So by doing this, there will be kind of a danger that the depositors' money might be taken over by these financial institutions. So now, it is the government that will not come to the rescue of the depositors. It is the depositors who need to take their decisions with respect to how the market forces are actually unwinding themselves. So this is all for this bill. Now, if you want any kind of more clarity on this topic, you can WhatsApp me at 84594000, and you can also join our offline classes in Delhi and Chandigarh. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.